Hello, I'm Charles from Appealing Environments, and welcome to my crystal podcast. Today I'm talking about this wonderful stone. Whoa, it's heavy. It's slippery too. Polished nicely. Hematite. In the rough form, this is what we'd see in nature. Now, this piece is called a kidney hematite. It kind of looks like kidney bumps, I guess. I'm not sure. Now, the Greek word for hematite is red. Now, what does this have to do with red? It's silvery, it's shiny, looks like a chrome bumper of a car. Well, essentially, it's iron oxide that's within. And if we drill through the stone, and I'll show you drilling process of drilling this little piece here into a pendant, what it looks like when I drill, because it actually bleeds. It bleeds red. So let's take a look at that video now of me drilling through a stone and watching the stone bleed. Okay, we're ready to begin, and I have my iron oxide, hematite, and we are going to drill through. And what you're watching for is the bleeding of the stone. So I've got it set up. I kind of pick where I'd like to drill through, and again, you're going to be watching for what it looks like as it bleeds. Very neat to watch. I always enjoy watching this stone being drilled. Little noise as I turn on the press, and then you get to watch. Here we go. Okay, and one thing you might be noticing is I didn't drill all the way through. So what I do is turn the stone over and I'll show you, just with a little marker, I mark a spot where I'm going to drill the other half of the stone from the other side. And the reason I do that is so that the drill bit doesn't crash through and break open a crater on the other side, as if you can go completely through. So here we go, the other half. Okay, and there you have it, as a hole all the way through both sides, and this will become a hematite pendant to be worn for grounding and protection, and a little blood detoxifier. Thank you. So like I explained, the Greek word for hematite is red. And hematite was used also for thousands of years, ground up to make red chalk. So red, the color of the root chakra, a connection with the earth frequency. So this stone helps us tether or connect with the earth and remind us that we're all earth beings. Maybe because of the gravity, the heaviness of the stone, it's actually almost twice as heavy as quartz. So if I had a similar size quartz piece, it would be twice as heavy, this stone. So reminding us that we're earth beings and need to be connected with the earth. So that's another great aspect of this stone. Now, the Egyptians used the stone by using the dust of iron oxide to lay on top of the sarcophagus. Now, why did they do that? Because iron oxide is poisonous if we breathe it in. So they would cover the sarcophagus with iron oxide so that thieves would stay away, wouldn't tamper with what's inside the sarcophagus, obviously. So that's just another part of hematite, or a little bit of history with it. for us. Another piece of history would be in New York City, we have the brownstone fronts. And what are those? Those are buildings or houses that used sandstone from the Connecticut Valley. And in Connecticut Valley, they have the sandstone is heavily laden with iron oxide. And when iron oxide is of course, exposed to the elements, it turns red or a rusty color. So that's essentially where we get the brownstone fronts buildings in New York City. A lot of people ask me about magnetized hematite. Now, I discourage or I steer away from magnetized hematite. And I know why, and I try to explain to people that it's not natural. Now, a lot of people think that hematite is naturally magnetized, and it's not. And actually, there is a very small magnetic field, but we could never really call this a magnet where it would stick to something. So it holds a very small magnetic charge naturally, but not nearly enough for us to call it a magnet. So where do these things come from? These things that look like hematite, most people think they're hematite, and they're magnetic. So essentially, this is a synthetic product, man-made, or factory-made, we'll call it. It's a ceramic barium strontium ferric magnet, which means it's got no hematite in it at all. It's not hematite like we know this piece to be, all right? Or this piece being the kidney hematite, right? These two things are not the same, and essentially, they don't even attract to each other. Well, there's a little bit of pull because iron oxide, iron, and magnets like to come together. Definitely on the steel ruler, there it is. So what are the healing properties of wearing a fake magnetic hematite bracelet? Well, there is some healing effects of magnets, of course. The healing effects can be from taking some heavy metals out of my body, concentrating them in one place so that my organs of my body are no longer subjected with heavy metals. So in our bloodstream, we have a number of heavy metals. And how they got there is through ingestion, inhalation, and absorption. And from factory smoke, we call it volatile organic chemicals, the foods we eat or bioaccumulation from say fish or different food groups that have metals or heavy metals within them, either in the soil, in the food, or in the, you know, even the plankton, the zooplankton, the fish eat the zooplankton, and the bigger fish eats the smaller fish, etc., until we in the food chain come along and eat those items with the heavy metals. We bioaccumulate, which means we never release it, it's stored inside us, and it's floating around in our bloodstream or circulating throughout our body. So wearing a magnet, say as a bracelet, yeah, sure, there's some temporary, and I call it temporary because if I take the bracelet off, I'm now have the my blood is circulating all the heavy metals again, and I feel the ill effects of the toxics of those. Wearing a bracelet does help. And I can't say don't to wear it or take it off if you are wearing it, but just so you know, you're not getting any healing effects of the actual hematite. This one, again, is synthetic and artificially made, and most of the companies that make them have a trade secret, meaning the formula that makes up this look-alike hematite magnetized is not so. Now, there is a natural way of magnetizing hematite. A real hematite, naturally. Now what they do is attach a very strong magnet to it, like this one, but much stronger. And then they heat and cool, heat and cool, heat and cool a number of times the hematite, and it will, the iron oxide, will hold the charge. And that's how they create magnets, essentially, by attaching a bigger one to it and then heating it and cooling it in a process to hold the charge. So it will line up the molecules to accept a charge. So the molecules within natural hematite don't like to line up to make a magnet per se. So we know that sometimes magnets will point in a direction and opposite, so you know you have to attach them a certain way or they'll flip around. Well, that's just because of the lineup of molecules within a magnet or magnetized synthetic hematite. So the real hematite, what can it do for us? The real hematite, you know, the one that isn't synthetic or factory made, we call it, right? This helps us connect with the earth. It's a heavy stone overall, so it tethers us to the earth frequency and allows us to connect with Mother Nature, we'll call it. Now, it also helps us connect through our sciatic nerve. So our root chakra is where our sciatic nerve, and a sciatic nerve runs from our foot, the heel of our foot, literally the pad of our foot, all the way up our legs, both sides, there's two of them, through our hip bone and into our spinal column, right at the very bottom. And the size of the nerve, now if you imagine, a nerve is just an information highway. The size of the nerve, this is the longest running nerve in our body, but the thickness is about as thick as my thumb when it goes through my hip. So there's a tremendous amount of information, and really it's just the information from the earth, my legs, coming into my spinal column, to my brain, to tell me that I'm connected or in ease and not in dis-ease. Hematite allows us or helps us build that connection through our sciatic nerve with the earth. So if you have sciatica, maybe hematite may help thwart, or some exercises as well can also help with it. Now, it's a protective stone, and it's protective because of the reflective properties as well. So because it's so reflective, it allows us to see ourselves. And we don't often look at ourselves. So this stone allows us to look within, to look at ourselves as a human being, as a species, as a love being. And this stone will help us do that and rebalance us with the earth. So, a little information about hematite. I hope you enjoyed. Come back again and we'll see another crystal podcast by Charles Brand of Appealing Environments. Have a great day. Thanks.